had the pleasure of introducing you yesterday into the more fast and simplistic method. I wouldn't say I appreciate you first period. Eighth period, whenever I was looked, and I gave them like this one that went forever and a day on order of limitations. It's like, didn't that take a long time? No.
Jerk.
Thank y'all for accepting the fact that, yeah, that might have only took 2 minutes.
Yeah,
dear God,
if we
can do something in 30 seconds, why do we want to spend 2 minutes?
I mean, shoot, we've done conversions in under 2 minutes.
That's right. Got all these people sitting.
Not saying we did them right, but we did them.
I will also let you guys know, because we're getting close to it, planning-wise for next week, because this Friday is the lab, and next Friday is supposed to be the quiz. But the issue is I may be gone next week. I'll be here on the 8th, guaranteed, but I may be gone the 9th and 12th.
And we got 2 days off, don't we?
Yeah.
Yes, you have midweek off. So I'm letting you know, it's going to be Monday before I know, because I'm having to wait to see if some mics that these churches in Maine have got ordered, if they're coming in and they get shipped, then I'm going to Maine. But if they don't, then I'm not going to Maine. So I will let you know, I'll be shooting a message out to you guys on Remind, because it will not be Monday morning, and I will know. It'll be somewhere in the afternoon. So if you want to, you can swing by and ask. I'll let you know what's going to happen, whether I'll be here or not. All right. If I'm not here and we have to move the quiz, we will move the quiz. But I'm not going to move it to the next Friday, because that is the Friday before Thanksgiving break. And let's all just be honest, I love you all dearly, and I love all 8th period dearly. Some of y'all are going to head out for an early vacay. I'm not dumb. I still will cover material, but I want to let you know, I'm going to move that quiz, all right? And then we'll come back after that week, and it's Christmas. Woo! Now,
it's already Christmas.
That's how I feel. I felt like that last month. Everybody's like,
yeah,
you're
kidding. Yeah, you still
have to have like decorations in here on this day.
I honestly thought about it. I really
did. I was
did.
Like, there's going to be a Christmas tree somewhere.
No. Hey, I say we take a day and we decorate.
Electron configuration. So we left off with this yesterday, okay? So I want to get you into the swing of it, doing electron configurations without actually looking at an orbital notation. So let's do, for the fun of it, topic number 12, magnesium. So whenever you do this, it's just like before. You're going to find your element.
We find our element. Magnesium, atomic number 12.
Mark it. From this point, whenever we mark it, we're also going to put on there, put a note for your stopping point. So here's magnesium. So you can see which block is magnesium in. Thank you.
I thought it was rhetorical.
It's okay. So it's in the S block. So that means the energy level is equal to the rho. So what is the energy level?
2.
3. So 3S. Then we see how far into the S block it goes. Sodium's 1, magnesium's 2, so it's 3S2. All right, just like what I said yesterday, pretty sure I mentioned this to y'all, I'm not going to like flip a table and be upset with you if you look at me and say 3S squared, but it's actually 3S2. I don't want you to go to college and people be like, you're stupid kid, really.
No, if you think about it, it's a good conversation starter. That's how you make new friends.
That's true.
So just mess up.
If you got to mess up once, so people come and look at you, like, hey, who is that guy? And then they come and talk to you. Because first it starts with a joke, and then they realize how cool you are. And yeah. How you know how to, like, milk a cow and stuff, and then they're really crazy over it. Trust me.
I wish I would have had that advice. I was just a loud-mouthed idiot that walked in the classroom. Walked in my good novels class, which, let me tell you something, might have been called good novels, but it was like, oh, my sweet God, this class sucks novels. And it's like I just walked in, and there's a whole class there, and I'm like, anybody else dreading this class? I hate English. This sucks. First words out of my mouth.
They all looked at you.
They all probably.
Nope, they all looked. And then a couple of them start laughing. Then next thing I know, a couple of them start talking with me. And it's like, I broke the ice. It was perfect. It was wonderful. And I will also say this to those people in the room, that you got a thick country accent like me, it's not a bad thing. Some people's going to make fun of you. Some people are going to laugh at you. I will also look at you and tell you, it is a very nice thing. I don't know how many meals I had at the dining hall where pretty girls just wanted to sit with me and talk. And they just wanted to hear me talk. And I was like, well, I sweet thing, you sit there and I'll talk to you as long as you want. Exactly. Alright. Anyway, back to the game. So magnesium. So you always start at the top, top left, hydrogen. So we go through the 1s, 1s2. And it's 1s2 because we went all the way through it. So what's after 1s2?
2s.
2s2, keep going, 2p6, 3s2, how do you know it's it?
That's where
we stopped. We made the note, worked like a beautiful thing. You getting a feel for it? This is literally this simple. You know how I normally have tricks? Mr. Hall has no tricks. I know, you're shocked. You're like, he's lying. There's no way this is truthful.
This is the part where we're crawling, trying to unstake, I guess.
This is the thing, is that there is no trick. Just follow the patterns. Follow the rules. Know the rules.
The thing is, like, when you say there's no tricks, that's what makes it suspicious that there's something you're hiding. But when you don't say anything, it's just kind of like, oh, okay, that's all it is.
Well, if there was a trick, I would give it to you.
It's like reverse psychology.
There's something I could add to it, but I'm just going to do it later. It'll all change later, but it kind of like, it works later that I add it because it, you know how I told you, everything comes together. This is what will happen. It will come together and work perfectly for you. Okay?
Nice.
Very nice.
Okay. Number 32.
Talk number 32, germanium. Right?
Yes. No, no, no.
Yes, it is germanium.
That's just my guess.
Yeah. You do it. I give you like a minute.
You can do it.
That is germanium. One S two P six. 3S2, 3P6. 4S2, 3D10. You gotta catch that. Then 4P2.
Yeah.
Any questions? All right, let's give you a long one. Still working, keep working. Anybody got a question on this? So I got 1S2, 2S2, 2P6, 3S2, 3P6, 4S2, 3D10, 4P6, 5S2, 4D10, 5P6, 6S2, 4F14, 5D10, 6P6, 7S2, 5F10.
I read 502 and 503 in my head. I really did.
I can't remember which one it was, but when it was like an awkward pause in me, like I broke the rhythm. It's good. I think it's 6S. I almost went 6S squared and I went, stop. It's not squared. It's not squared. It's not squared. 6S2. So a couple spots to note here is here, because of the 3D. Same thing here, but the 4D. Then this whole freaky jumping back to the fourth with the 4F. Are you guys getting the pattern? Are you getting the flow? Remember how I told you we're going to do these, you're going to love these, and you're going to keep asking for them? It's because it's just a pattern. You learn the pattern, you got it. There's nothing I can do to trick you. I know, sad, right? So sad. There's no trick, nothing here. But it's literally this simple. I'll do one more. Y'all just like so quiet today.
Freaking out. I didn't realize that was new. I did, but even after that game, I was not the right to be tired. It was a little while. The most I've done all year. Our cheering session was about 6 kids, about 20 parents, but it was definitely the loudest cheering session we've ever had.
It's the atomic number.
It was Ben Parker.
25. Manganese. Electron configuration for manganese.
Manganese.
Just walking around, you guys look solid. I got any questions? Got pretty easy. Yeah. Swear I could say like blood through all out and say that, you know, I'm gonna make this the hardest food you ever had in my life. It's probably one of the easiest ones. So 1S2, 2S2, 2P6, 3S2, 3P6, 4S2, 3D5. Right?
How many of these are you going to do with one day?
I ain't going to give you a bunch because it takes forever to do. I mean, imagine every kid I have to look at, every one of these. It sucks.
So one or two. Or one, three, because I'll have one of each. One of each notation or configuration, sorry.
Okay. Let's do this.
I don't want to be the squared guy.
Atomic number, I'm going to take the argon.
Is this the one that's going to make them make it?
Do what?
Is this the one that's going to trick us up?
Hopefully not.
I hope not. Okay. It's getting ready to serve a purpose. Still working, keep working, but already on, I got 1S2, 2S2, 2P6, 3S2, 3P6. Any questions?
Why'd you do it in red?
That's a good question. There's a purpose behind it. I just need that. Remember how I told you how many types of configurations we'll go through? You've learned two. You know how with orbital notation, electron configuration, it got a lot easier? You know what? Let's make it even easier. Yes. I'm going to give you the easiest one. It's the shortest one, and this is the one where you'll probably go, why didn't we start with this? I'm waiting for one of these days I scream like that, Miss Hogg, Miss Adams, like walking by, and they just come in like, everything okay?
But where you just missed or show up by about 10 minutes ago.
Noble gas configuration.
Well, I'm going to pay for this one.
Noble gas configuration. Let's define it. I still haven't turned the vocabulary stuff in yet. You'll probably come slacking here in a little bit. Alright, this is pretty hard.
You just said it was easy. Which one is it?
No, the definition's pretty hard.
Oh, that's
good. Going over this and take your time.
Uses the last noble gas in square brackets. Now, the key is it has to be in square brackets. Not parentheses. If you give me parentheses, I have to consider it wrong. Has to be square brackets. I'm warning you now, it has to be these square brackets. Okay? And don't look at me on your quiz and go, Mr. Hall, I tried drawing a square bracket. That ain't even that tall at a right angle. That ain't even close.
Oh, you see a straight line.
Exactly.
You're not sure. At least do a little bit. Put a little bit of a straight line, a little bit of a curve on the end. Oh, it's believable.
Just ask me. I'll put them in square brackets for you. All right, use the last noble glass in square brackets to substitute the sub in for the equal electron configuration. I think that makes sense.
So it's kind of like reverse?
Kind of. So I gave you the last two I gave you for a reason. Find what's the same. I lined it up like this on purpose. And I drew it on red for purpose. I needed a different color. This right here is the exact same thing. So what if I could just cut out that whole thing in the beginning? That's what this does. So let's do an a noble gas configuration for manganese. Atomic number 25, manganese. So here's the trick. And I'm telling you, I actually do this. I watch kids that do this on quiz day and they ace it. And I watch kids that don't do it on quiz day and they mess up. Take your finger on your periodic table. Find your element. So here we are. Manganese, right? So what you're going to do is here on manganese, put your finger on manganese. Go up a row. So I go from the fourth row to the third row and go all the way to the noble gases, which is the 18th column. So argon is the last one I covered. That's what I'm going to use to sub in. Now, key is 18th column are the noble gases. You'll learn later on why we call them the noble gases. But right now, just know where the noble gases are. So if I asked you, where is the noble gases, you can give them to me. So this is what we do. You find the noble gas. So we have argon in square brackets. You put the chemical symbol. Now, this is where I want to stress to you. It's a capital A, lowercase r. It matters. I will count it 100% incorrect if you give me a capital R. The rule when it comes to chemical symbols, first letter is capitalized, second letter is always lowercase. The reason we do this is when we write out chemical formulas, we can tell when there's an element change that way. Now, you change your starting point. As soon as I picked argon, I'm no longer starting at hydrogen. I'm starting after the noble gas I picked. In other words, we no longer are starting up here. You just substituted here. So all of this is filled in just by putting the argon in the square brackets. So now go after argon. I'm here, right? Which row is this? So it's 4S2. Then I go into what? 3D. How far in did you go? 3D5. That's it. So it's going to go right next to the square bracket. So now it's square bracket, argon, 4S2, 3D5. That simple. If there is a trick, if you want to consider a trick, do you think it's going to be a trick? I'm going to give this to you to show you that it's really not a trick. You just got to know what you're doing. If I ask for the noble gas configuration of radon, atomic number 86, radon, and I want a noble gas, I ask for this. This is the thing. Radon is a noble gas. You cannot just put radon in square brackets and say done. It's the last noble gas you covered. So you went through. So go to the periodic table.
I really need like a study hall person in here to just work my camera.
Good ask.
Nah, I let them come ask. I don't like run kids off. Find your element. Here's the element, radon. Radon is a noble gas. but you still follow the same rule. Put your finger on it. Go up a row. Go all the way over to the noble gases. I'm already there. Don't mean I have to go any farther, but I start at xenon. So then it's going to be xenon in the square brackets. So Xe. Start after xenon. So let's go 55. Here's cesium. What is this? 6S2. Good job. What comes after that? 4F. We go all the way through it. 4F, 14. You said it. 5D, 10. Then I go into the P. Went all the way through, right? So 6P6. That's the noble gas configuration for xenon. For radon, sorry. That's the thing. It's really not a trick. Kids just get mixed up. If I give you a noble gas, you still follow the same set of rules. It's that simple. Does it get any easier? No. Do you have any questions for me? I know everybody's blah this morning. Any questions? Going once. Why? Salt. Okay. So listen, this is what I'm going to do. I have a practice sheet on this, but I'm not going to give it to you yet, because I need something for you to work on Tuesday, when I may not be here. This is the good thing, because what's going to happen is that means Tuesday, you are not going to cover new material in the class. You'll have a practice sheet, because what we're going to continue on with now, we're going to flip it tomorrow. Tomorrow, we go into the quantum model of the atom. I'm going to have a lot of fun, because tomorrow I'm going to mess with your heads a little bit. With fun. It's a Dalton, don't miss. He does not want, nobody wants to miss tomorrow.